I, Professor Vishal Taylor, welcome to my YouTube channels. In this video, I teach you hydraulic accumulators in the details with the animation of hydraulic accumulators. In this video, I explain you function of hydraulic accumulators, its construction, working, its capacity and where it is used, means its application. So first we start with the function. So hydraulic accumulator is used to store the energy. Okay, so every energy is in three forms. Okay, so it is either in pressure energy, it is kinetic energy and potential energy. So hydraulic accumulator is used to store the energy of a liquid in the form of pressure energy. Okay, and this store energy may be supplied for any sudden or intermediate requirements, means it store and when it is required and it supply this energy. This hydraulic accumulator will use with the different hydraulic machines, like as the hydraulic press, hydraulic crane and lift. This is the press, this is the hydraulic lift and hydraulic cranes. So accumulator is used with these types of the devices. Now we all know that these type of devices is either moving in upper direction and downward directions. Okay, so when this device is moving in upper direction, then what is happen when it is moving downward direction, at that time what happened? So in this case of hydraulic lift or a crane, a large amount of energy is required when the lift or a crane is moving in upper direction and the energy is supplied from the hydraulic accumulators. Okay, so when this device is moving in upper direction, at that time hydraulic accumulator is supplied energy. Now another time what happened when this device is moving in downward direction? So when the device is moving in downward direction, they are not required any external energy. Okay, so during this period, the energy from the pump is stored in the accumulator. Okay, means what happened, this device is moving in upper direction, at that time accumulator is supplied energy, and this device is moving downward direction, at that time energy is stored in the accumulators. Okay, so accumulator used with different machines. So how its flow diagram? So first supply water is come to the pump, then high pressure energy from the pump is supplied to the accumulators. Either accumulator store it or supply it to the different hydraulic machine. So these are the flow diagrams. Okay, so anything you understand by the flow diagram, then it is easily to understand. If you learn something, then press the subscribe buttons to watch more videos and also press the bell icon to getting more update. Now next we understand the constructions and working. So I explain the working with the animations, and after that you not require to see this theory again. So first we understand this construction. Now in this construction there is a main three component. This is the fixed vertical cylinders. Cylinder means when you see this cylinder from the top view, then it gives you the circular shape. Okay, and this is the hollow cylinders. And another component is this sliding ramp. This sliding ramp means the ramp it slide inside this fixed cylinder. That's why it is known as the sliding ramp, because ramp motion is in sliding direction. And the third component, it is the weight that is put on the sliding ramp. That are the main three components. Then after you need to explain the construction of these cylinders. On the cylinder, one side inlet is provided. On the other side, there is an outlet from outlet that is supplied to the different hydraulic machines such as the lift, crane and the hydraulic press. And in an inlet there is a pump, as we earlier seen in the flow diagram. And this outlet of the cylinder is connected with the various machines, which may be lift, crane or a hydraulic press. So these are its construction. Next we move towards the working with complete animation. So watch the video up to the end for complete understanding. So next part, it's the working of a hydraulic accumulators. We understand the working of hydraulic accumulators. So at the beginning, when we start the hydraulic accumulators, the ramp positions, it is lowermost positions. Okay, then after the pump is start and the water is supplied from this pump. Okay, now when the hydraulic machines not require any pressure energy, then this water or liquid is stored inside the cylinders. and it will rise the ramp on which heavy weight is placed. Means when the water is stored in this place, the hydraulic ramp is start to moving in upper direction. Means this sliding ramp is moving in upper direction because the pressure energy of the liquid is applying the pressure on the sliding ramp and it's moving in upper direction like this way, and it's get the new positions. When the ramp is in uppermost positions, the cylinder is full of waters and the accumulator has stored the maximum amount of the pressure energy. It is known as the capacity of hydraulic accumulator. Means the sliding ramp is moving from these lowermost positions to uppermost positions. It is known as the capacity or amount of pressure energy stored. Now when the machines requires the pressure energy, then liquid stored inside the cylinder is start to supply to the different machine like crane, press and that. At that time the sliding ramp is start to moving in the direction, in a downward direction. That's where the continuous working of the hydraulic accumulators is run. Now next we find out the capacity of hydraulic accumulators. So capacity is defined as the maximum amount of hydraulic energy stored in the accumulator. Means how amount of the hydraulic energy stored in the accumulators. For that first we understand these different parameters. So let us take A is equal to area of the sliding ramp. So sliding ramp, its section view is circular. So area for the sliding ramp is equal to pi by 4 d square. Then after, L is equal to stroke or a lift of the ramp, means its distance from the lowermost positions to the topmost position. This length is known as the stroke length, L. And the P is equal to intensity of the water pressure supplied by the pump. Means this force acting, it has a certain intensity, it is known as the P. And last term is the W, that is a weight placed on the ramp. That is known as the W. Now next, load on the ramp means how amount of the load act on this ramp is equal to the intensity of this pressure P into area of the ramp. The area is pi by 4 d square, and the P is the here arrow is indicating the P intensity of the force. Then from this load on the ramp we are find out the work done in lifting the ramp. Means how amount of the work is utilized to lifting the ramp from lowermost position to uppermost. So work done is equal to W into lift of arm. So this work done is equal to W into L. So W is equal to P into A. So final equation is PA into L. The work done in lifting the ramp is also the energy stored in the accumulator, and the energy equal to the capacity of the accumulator. Means the work done required to lifting the ramp and energy stored in accumulators both are same. So capacity of the accumulator is equal to work done in lifting the ramp, that is a P into area into length, and area into length is considered as the volume. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels.